Welcome back. The AI reference kits from Intel in collaboration with Accenture. There are many of them, they are free and open source, and they could be your first step to an AI-based product. Last video, we have overviewed the full flow of the visual inspection reference kit. The goal is to identify defected peels at a product line. And in this video, we'll run the full flow together, step by step. As I mentioned, this reference kit could be applied to many types of products, not only peels, and this is what I'll demonstrate in the next video. So this is the full flow. You can find the link to the GitHub page in this QR code or in this video description. If you navigate to the GitHub page, you'll find all the explanations you need. There are clear instructions for Windows, but I'll run the flow on my Ubuntu machine. Here is the link to the sample dataset used as reference. You'll have to download it yourself. And the first thing to do is to clone the repository and get into the Visual Quality Inspection directory. And now we can create the Conda environment. So first, we are creating an environment for the stock, the regular PyTorch distribution. Later, we'll build an environment for the Intel PyTorch one. Under env/stock, you can find the YAML file with the required versions for each package. And let's create the environment. It can take a while, but once it's there, just conda activate and you are in. And conda deactivate and you are out again. Pretty clean and easy to maintain multiple different environments like that. So let's create the other environment for the Intel extension for PyTorch. We'll call it AI Kit environment, and you can see the versions in the corresponding YAML file. And again, getting into or out of the environment is easy. And we're all set with the environment. And now to the dataset itself. I've downloaded the peels dataset. Make sure you are in the top directory. Let's unzip it. The unzip will locate all the images under the directory peel. Let's create directories under data for training and testing, for good and for bad examples. Get into the peels directory and we copy the dataset to the right places under data for training and for testing. And now let's train the model. There are several scripts that could help us. They are all under the top hierarchy /src. The first one is training.python. If you look at the main function, you can see that we are parsing the parameters, and here we are hard coding some of them, like the batch size, accuracy, and number of epochs. My device will be CPU, and here we are loading the data and loading the custom VGG model. If you'd like to see the model definition itself, look under utils and open the model file. You can see that the model is the original VGG 16, but at line 39, we are freezing the first 23 layers. Loading the weights, measuring the time it takes for training, and running the actual training. Let's run training. Before you do that, make sure you are in the PyTorch stock conda environment and run the training. Dataset was found and training is done. Accuracy is 91.3% and it took 70 seconds to train. You can see the saved models, peel intel model.h5 and the .onyx file. And now, let's run the same training using IPEX, Intel extensions for PyTorch. Let's get out of the stock environment, get into the IPEX environment, and rerun the training process. 38 seconds, almost half the time of the regular PyTorch. So, let's evaluate the model. We are running inference, first using PyTorch. We'll use the PyTorch evaluation script. Let's look at it. Under /source, you can see that we are parsing the arguments, setting the device, loading the model, and measuring the time for the function evaluate. Let's make sure we are in the stock PyTorch Conda environment and evaluate. Make sure to change the model name and running. This can take some time to run all the test samples. And we got to accuracy of 92%. Test time was 101 seconds. Now let's do the same with the Intel extension for PyTorch. Get into the environment and run the evaluation again. The accuracy looks the same, 92%, but the runtime is 3 times faster, only 30 seconds. Pretty cool, considering the fact that it's on the same hardware, using the same code. So far, we have set the environment, arranged the dataset, trained using PyTorch and IPEX, and ran inference, evaluation of the performance of the model in PyTorch and IPEX. You've seen how IPEX is faster, in my case, 2 or 3 times faster than PyTorch for the same code. But all of this was done using FP32 weights. Now, let's take the model and quantize it to integer 8 bits. We'll do it using INC, Intel Neural Compressor. So, we'll be using the Neural Compressor that can do much more than just quantization. Make sure you are in the stock PyTorch environment. Navigate to the Intel Neural Compressor directory. You can see here our scripts. Let's look at the conversion script. Parsing the arguments, loading the model, and here comes the quantization. The code looks pretty simple. And now, let's just run it. Make sure to get the model name right. Dataset found, baseline is FP32, and we are getting a report on how many layers of each type were converted to int 8, and how did the accuracy change, and we got a quantized model at the output directory. Now, let's use the other script for inference. This script will run inference using the FP32 model and the int 8 model and compare the results. It's using batch 1. You can, of course, change all the parameters. And looks like the average inference using int 8 is 10 times faster than the FP32 on my machine, on an i9 CPU, with the accuracy still high at 93%. Very nice. So just a quick summary. Training the model using PyTorch took me 70 seconds. Training using Intel extensions for PyTorch IPEX took 38 seconds. Inference using PyTorch took 340 milliseconds. Inference using IPEX took about 100 milliseconds. And this is all floating point 32. Inference using the int 8 model took about 60 milliseconds. Can it get better than that? Well, it can. Let's take the model to OpenVINO. We will first just run inference using OpenVINO on the FP32 model, then quantize the model using OpenVINO quantization tools and compare the inference time. First thing is to set a new Conda environment for OpenVINO and activate that environment. In the source directory, you can find the ONX trained model, and this is our starting point. Now, we have to use the model optimizer to convert it to the OpenVINO IR format. We're using the ONX file, and it takes a second to convert. We got a bin file and an XML file. This is our model in IR format. Next step is to benchmark the performance. So we are using the benchmark app on this model. Pay attention that I'm not providing any input data and I'm running it without any parameters. And it's just running. The default is to run inference for a minute and report the average. And we are getting an average latency of 54 milliseconds and about 73 FPS inferences per second, which means inference time of about 13 seconds. And now let's use the OpenVINO quantization. Under env/OpenVINO POT, you can find few configuration files. Let's look at the int 8 YAML file. Make sure that the directories are correct. I had to change it. Basically, you should have here links to all the required files, and you can play with the type of quantization and more. Let's run the POT, post-training optimization script. Make sure you are in the top directory and it is running. This is the result directory. Let's look at the original neural network. It is the XML file. Let's look for FP32. And all the weights are FP32 on the original model. Now, let's look at the quantized network. You can see here several FP32, but also some INT8 layers, as there will be a mixture of some layers that remain FP32 and some that were converted to integer. And now, let's run the benchmark app on the new model, and we are getting 116 FPS, much better than the 73 FPS we got for the FP32 model. And this is my summary on my specific i9 machine. It will of course look totally different on your machine. Anyway, the speed up of IPEX, Intel extension for PyTorch, over the stock PyTorch is pretty clear. Quantization to INT8 benefit is really clear. And the huge speed up gained by using OpenVINO and the quantized mode by OpenVINO is also clear. So we ran the full flow of the visual inspection reference kit. In the next video, we'll go a little deeper into the flow and talk about using your own dataset for your specific problem. Subscribe, enjoy, see you there.